and oocytes. So methods of grouping, there are slide method, tube technique, and matrix gel coat method. Recently, matrix gel coat method is the new technique for detecting blood grouping and typing. So now we can see demo of blood grouping and typing. So the slides are here, and three antibodies are there. Micropipette is here, the sample is here, and anti-A is blue in color. It is due to trypan blue. And anti-B is yellow in color. It is due to tartrazine. So we are marking A, B, and D. We are taking blood sample with the help of micropipette. And we are placing A column. Ensure you have to mark A, B, and D. Now we adding anti-A, which is blue in color. It is due to trypan blue. It is monoclonal anti-A. Now we adding anti-B. It is due to tartrazine. Now we adding anti-D. It is a white transparent fluid. So we have to rotate this slide. But we can rotate the slide in a circular motion. No need to mix with this type micropipette. So now you can see agglutination, like dot here, and in D column, if it is T, there is a presence of B antigen that is Rh positive. There is a presence of B antigen. You can see some dot agglutination is here. So here there is no agglutination. So you can see here small micro dots in the periphery. So it is B positive. Okay, it is a tube method. If we have time, we can see at the last. So what is this? I think you have ate the lunch. Let's start. Any comment section? Any guesses? What is this? Okay. It's not moving. Okay. So let's alert. These are Viva questions for examination. Why anti-A is blue in color? I hope you know the answer. And why anti-B is yellow in color? It is due to tartrazine. And ABO group is a protein or carbohydrate. It is a carbohydrate. Can we detect the blood group by using CSF? Any comments? No, it is not. We cannot detect the blood group antigen in CSF. Please note it down. Anti-A is blue in color due to trypan blue. So we can see matrix gel coat method because we are doing here also. It's an innovative approach to red cell serology. It's invented by Dr. Avis Lepier of France. Its serum and cell reaction takes place in a microtube. There are six microtubes in a plastic coat. This microtube consists of a reaction chamber that narrows down to become a column with a conical bottom. And the reaction chamber is designed to allow proper incubation of test serum and RBCs. And each column contains a separate gel suspended buffer solution. So you can see these are six columns are there. These are gels, that is sepacryl gels, and this is A column, it's anti-A, B and D positive control, and we can add here red cells actually, and this is we're adding antibodies. So here this gel will not allow the blood to go settle down if there is any agglutination. If there is agglutination, this blood will not go to the tube because the gel will prevent the agglutination reactions. So here, anti-A, that is A is negative. See, B, in the B, we can see the blood is staying in the upside. So it's a B positive. So B, and there is also plus of 4-H antigen. So it's a B positive blood group. In B positive, there will be anti-A. So anti-A is presented in up, okay? And B anti-B is negative. So it is B positive. So here you can see A negative, it's B negative, but RH is positive. So both antibodies, anti-A and anti-B. So it is O positive, okay? Here also, absence of A antigen, presence of B antigen, presence of RH, and here there is a presence of anti-A. So B antigen, anti-A, it is B positive. So here also, presence of B antigen, presence of A antigen, presence of RH antigen is a B positive. Presence of A antigen, absence of B antigen, presence of RH, and presence of anti-B, it is A positive. Can anyone diagnose this blood group? What is this? Yes, Sheetal is, yes, very good. It is Bombay blood group. You can see all antigens are negative, anti-A, anti-B, and here we adding anti-H also here. So it is Bombay blood group. Very good. It's not moving. So can anyone guess this food? Comment section. I hope you had lunch. Okay. Yes, it's South Indian food. Think there is a problem in moving of next slide. So, my question is, name the gel used in the technique. It is Cepadex. What is the other function of gel coat technique? And you message me in the mail for this question. Okay, next we can go cross-matching. So what is cross-matching? It's the most important serological and fundamental procedure responsible for the safe blood transfusion. So cross-match is carried out to ensure that there is no antibodies present in patient serum. What is the function? It is a final check of the ABO incompatibility between the donor and the patient to prevent the hemolytic transfer reaction. The two types are there. One is major and one is minor. In major, donor results with patient serum. In minor reaction, patient cells with donor serum. The principle is to detect any serological incompatibility. So, preparation of donor cells for cross-matching, we have to select appropriate unit of blood from the inventory. Inventory is nothing but the tube is attached to the blood pack. And we have to check for donor ID, blood group, expiry date, hemolysis or leakage. And we have to detach a segment from the blood pack and cut ends of segments and pour the contents in the labeled test tube. And we have to prepare the washed red blood cells. So this is the procedure. We have to label areas. The labeling is so important. After preparing suspension of red cells, we have to add 2 drops of patient serum in the major cross-matching, 2 drops of donor serum, the minor cross-matching. In major, we are using the patient serum and donor red cells. In minor, we are using the patient's red cells and donor serum, okay? And add 1 drop of 20% donor red cells in the major and 20% patient red cells in the minor cross-matching. We have to mix the content and exam for agglutination, okay? So here the patient serum and donor RBCs, 2 drops, and incubation for 1 hour and 3 washes and 2 drops of human globulin unmixed properly, we have to see the agglutination. So here there is agglutination, so it is incompatible for transfusing the blood. Here there is no agglutination, it is compatible. So whenever you go to blood bank and you are collecting the blood for the patient, they will take the, you will go with the, your patient sample and they will cross match your sample and they will prepare the slide with this blood and they will allow you to see the slides on the microscope and you have to see whether it is agglutination or there or not. Okay, so this is agglutination. If you see this type of agglutination, so it is incompatible for the patient and these are role formation. You can see stake of coins. If you see this type, it is compatible and we can transfuse the blood. We should not wrongly interpret it is agglutination, okay? So GelCoat, and this is a new technique. It is for in our MAMC also. The same thing, we have to add the reactants, plasma cells, and the same thing. Here also donor cell and recipient serum. Just 15 minutes and incubation at 37 degrees Celsius, we have to centrifuge and later we can see like this. So there's a grading is here. If there is full of blood, it's a hemolysin we should not use. And you can see completely it's settled. It is like agglutination is there, okay? So if there is 4+, it settles. It is incompatible. It is 3+, just diffusing. It is 2+, throughout the diffusing. In 1+, it little from the start, okay? Here plus or minus. If it settles down, then we can transfuse the blood actually, okay? So it is a compatible for transfusion because there is no settling of the blood at the upper side. It is compatible. It's a grading. And here also you can see this hemolyzed sample full of blood, red in color. It is 4+. So it is unsafe. Okay, we should not say we should not give the sample. Let's we should not. Here also it is compatible. You can see all are settling in the bottom. And here also it is compatible. It is a Coombs GelCoat. It is available in our LNH hospital. The same thing. It is another technique called immediate spin technique, but the temperature is 22 degrees Celsius. The disadvantage is the IgG will not be detected here. So can you guess this place? It's in South India. No, it's not Munnar. It is Nilgiris. Okay. So what is okay? Maximum H antigen present in which blood group? Anyone? Yes, Kartikeyan. It is in Nilgiri Hills only. Yes, very good. It's the O blood group. Very intelligent people, I think. All are. Now we can see anticoagulants in the blood group. So blood bag, sorry. And the ratio is 1:7. And these are the anticoagulants, ACD, acid citrate, dextrose, citrate phosphate dextrose, and citrate phosphate dextrose adenine, and saline adenine glucose mannitase, a recent anticoagulant. The self-life for this is 42 days. The purpose of citrate is to prevent the coagulant. It's like a chelating calcium. Dextrose, it will need for metabolism of stored RBCs, and phosphate is for increase 2.3 BPG, and adenine to improve the viability of the red cells, for mannitol to the hemolysis. And the capacity of blood bag is 50 ml and potassium is available in our blood bank. So this is your blood bag, empty blood bag. It is 350 ml. It is anticoagulant CPDA, citrate, phosphate, dextrose and adenine. And you can see here, the contents are written here. In this collection date, expiry date, we have to they will mention, and which group and RH typing is there or not, we have to mention here. So this is, what is the difference between the normal fridge and this blood bank fridges? There is no freezer compartment here, and there is no stand also in the door, inside of the door. So they are properly arranged like this. So all are should be separated. And this is A column, B column, AB, it depends upon the blood bank. And no food should be kept here, okay? And the blood bag should be kept not on the slant, it should be always kept upright position. So sorry, it is here you can see, it's like an inverted image. Here you can see the milk is kept here. It is wrong method. We should not keep like this. And this is an incubator. You can see in the blood bank, it's an incubator. And A blood group is yellow. See, A is yellow, there's yellow sticker. And B is pink sticker. They have green color coding for all the blood groups in our blood bank. And AB is white in color. And O positive is blue in color, okay? So how they are storing the platelets in our blood bank? Let's see. Platelet should be always be agitated. If it is not agitated, then bacteria and it will get gross. At room temperature, we have to maintain. This is a method for storing the platelets. We should not allow the microorganism to grow in the platelets. Always be in an agitated motion, platelets. Whenever you collect the platelets, we also get agitate the platelets, okay, till patient transfusion. Can you guess this hills? It's a true photo. It's a true picture. Yes, it is a Cooley Hills. Okay, what are the types of donors we can? It's a voluntary donor, a person who donates the blood of his or own free will and receives no payment for it. Okay, it is a voluntary donor. And family replacement blood donor, a person who gives a replacement unit of blood only when a family member or friend requests transfusion. Who is a paid donor, a person who provides the blood for money or other form of the payment. Who is autologous donor, a patient who donates his or her blood to be stored and reinfused if needed during surgery for herself. These are four types of donor. So how we are selecting the donor process? So we have two registration should be done. There should be pre-donation information is there. I will show that form and that should be completed by the donor. And there will be interview and counseling and donor health and risk assessment. Okay, then we can go. These are the prerequisites. A should be 18 to 65 years, weight more than 45 kg and no fever and pulse. There should be normal rhythm and pulse listed to 100 beats per minute and HP is more than 12.5 gram per deciliter. BP should be 100 to 140, diastolic to 90 mm of mercury, no tattoo in 6 months. Pregnant and lactating mothers are excluded, no significant weight loss and no skin rash. So these are the donor forms in our MAMC hospital. So they're asking question, do you feel well today and do you sleep well last night? These are the questions they are asking in our blood form. So have you something to eat at the last 4 hours? We have to tick all those things, have to fill all those things. So here, tattooing, ear piercing, dental extraction, acupuncture, major surgery, minor surgery, unexplained weight loss. In these patients, we have to defer the blood group, okay? And second things, we having heart disease or cancer or any malignancies, we have to fill all those things. Okay, now we can discuss the case. So now we are going to a proper discussion of the case of transfer reactions. It is a general tabular column as acute and delayed reactions. You can take a photo of this. It's a very important flowchart for your examinations also. Let's go into our ward. Case one, a patient undergoing blood transfusion develops raised erythematous patch in the skin associated with itching. What you will do next? Any answer? Okay. Stop transfusion. Okay, let's see what happens. So before that, what is raised erythematous patch? We'll see the picture. You can see erythematous background with the raised raised patch. That is patch number more than 0.5 centimeter. Okay. the reaction the patient experienced after this. Yes, it is the most commonest febrile non-hemolytic reaction. Is the most common. We have to stop the transfusion immediately. What is the definition of this? 1 degree temperature rise associated with the transfusion. No medical explanation other than the blood transfusion. What is the cause? The patient has immunologic sensitization to the donor WBCs, platelets or plasma proteins. These are signs and symptoms of the patient will experience this. Nausea, chills and cough and cyanosis and dyspnea. These are the most unrelevant findings. The patient will have itching, sometimes hypotension also. So antipyretics are used to treat fever or given as preventive measures before the transfusion also and discontinue this transfusion. And these are the steps we have to take. We should notify to the physician and we notify to concerned chief also and basic medical checks of all forms, labels and patient identification of the correctness of the unit and all things we should take. And we have to collect the sometime urine samples also if the patient is experiencing hemoglobinuria. The patient complains of I have pausing doctor urine like that, okay, and should document it also in the case sheet. So you can see after collection of sample, you can see the whether it is agglutination there or not. You can check in visual check also, hemolyzed sample. What are the other tests? We can do cross matching also, haptoglobin, bilirubin, and urine hemoglobin by indicating hemolytic process. So this is a mechanism why the patient is getting allergy means is due to IgE, or as you know, it is IgE, it will attach the mast cells, it will do histamines to attack areas. How will you manage this patient? We have to inject antihistamines. If signs and symptoms, we have to restart. It is after settling. Do not restart transmission if pulmonary symptoms signs are present. Okay. So what is the reason for every misunderstanding? Yes. Okay, case 2. A gynec PG resident asked the intern to get the urgent blood for 2 different patients. And he or she got the blood and returned to the labor ward and start transfusing immediately. Both the patient's name was same with same age group. After a few minutes of transfusion, both patients complaining of pausing dot color urine. What you will do next? Any comments? We have to stop the transfusion. Any guesses? Can anyone make the diagnosis? Yes, hemolysis is occurring, yes, definitely. Yes. It is acute hemolytic transfusion reaction. Yes, it's acute hemolytic reaction. The most common cause ABO incompatibility is a clerical error. Even 10 to 15 ml can trigger a reaction. What are all the causes? So incompatible donor RBCs into the patients and most common is ABO incompatibility. The complement or release of C3 and C5A are reduced. C3 and C5A will cause hypotension and mast cells, that's called histamine and serotonin, cause ischemia of the renal vessels. Release of bradykinin B is due to increase the vascular permeability and cytokines that cause hypotension and antigen-antibody interaction will increase the coagulation cascade. All will result in DIC and renal failure. These are all the most signs and common signs symptoms of acute hemolytic reaction. Mainly is renal failure, DIC and shock. So stop the transfusion, keep IV open with normal saline, check all the blood components, labels, forms, patient ID for errors. Usually it's a clerical error, notify the physicians as appropriately and treat the reaction and notify the blood bank also. And submit the report forms and submit what specimens also. It is a high risk of morbidity or mortality. So we have to manage according to the cause, hypotension, failure and DIC. We have to submit everything. The same thing I've written here. So how we can preventing or detecting errors at every phase is very important actually. Sample acquisition at all and during the testing at the time of issuing and the time of transfusion also is important. And perform pre-transmission combat testing properly actually. Ensure that all the clinical staff recognize signs and symptoms of the acute reaction. These are of the lab investigations, like direct Coombs test, as you said previously, urine hemoglobinuria, serum bilirubins, and urea creatinine, and urine output and screening of coagulation. Third case, a 45-year male develops dyspnea within 6 hours of transfusion, associated with fever and leukopenia. So saturation is 85%. What we will do next? What is the diagnosis? Yes, Prasanna, it is trali. What is trali full form? Yes, severe dyspnea, cyanosis, tachycardia, hypoxemia, hypotension, fever, and chills. It's a trali. Symptoms occur within 2 hours and may end in 2 to 4 days if treated. Patient displays acute respiratory insufficiency with the X-ray showing bilateral pulmonary edema. It's a pathophysiology of trali. Leukocyte antibodies in donor react with patient leukocytes and activate complements. Adherence of the granulocytes to pulmonary endothelium with the release of enzymes and the damage of endothelium, there will be the interstitial edema and the pedalvioli. These are all the causes. The donor antibodies will activate the patient WBCs or vice versa, which cause the damage of red blood cell tissues. Similar to ARDS. So treat with IV steroids, although they may not work well actually. The prevention is avoid donation from the multiparous women and those who have received multiple transfusion also. And steroids and ventilator support and hemodynamic support for these patients. Okay. A PG resident asks the newly joined intern to transfuse the blood to the patient who is anemic with Hb 5.5. An intern got the blood from the blood bank and started transfusing, and the transfusion was completed within 1 hour. Okay. In between the transfusion, he went to Nescafe to enjoy his friend's birthday without informing to anyone in the world. A poor PG resident already frustrated with the admission day, taking rest in the DDR, with his duty doctor's room. And nursing officer rushed to the DDR with his loaded voice, awakes the poor PG resident. Let's see what happens. Any guesses? HP is 5.5. The patient age is 65. You guess. Yes. It's a taco. What is taco? Yes, it is transfusion associated circulatory overload, and children, elderly patients, chronic anemia, cardiac disease, and even thalassemia major, sickle cell disease, all are prone for this TACO. The pathophysiology is volume overload. The patient is both for CCF and edema ultimately. So how we can differentiate trali and TACO means presence of fever and associated leukopenia in trali, whereas in TACO, there is no fever and no leukopenia, okay? And trali manifests hypotension, whereas in TACO manifests as hypertension due to volume overload along with raised jugular venous pressure. So due to volume overload, the heart chamber is going to get distended. So at the time, brain natriuretic peptide will be released. And you can ask me, it is a brain natriuretic peptide. It is not secreted from the brain. It is secreted from the heart. Okay, it is a misnomer. So in TACO, BNP is increased while it's normal in trali. Okay. In TACO, there is hypertension. In trali, there is hypotension because of histamine. In trali, there will be leukopenia. In TACO, nothing will be there. There is no fever also. BNP is increased in TACO. It's normal in trali. What is therapy for this? Rapid reduction of hypovolemia, respiratory and cardiac support, and oxygen therapy and diuretics to prevent the volume over. The thing is, the mistake is, we should transfuse the blood for 4 hours actually. We should not, transfuse the blood also. And we should always intimate the other residents, I'm going outside, just you can see and wash and carefully monitor the patients. We should not do like this. If you are transfusing the blood, we should wait until the blood is done completely. Okay. We can see some delayed reactions. Like graft versus host disease and transmission malaria. And these are the risk factors: immunocompromised, newborn and geriatric patients, bone marrow transplantations, chemotherapy, radiation treatment, and these are all the patients more prone for this disease. So pathophysiology is the infusion of immunocompetences and patient at risk and proliferation of donor T lymphocytes that will attack the patient tissues. So onset is 3 to 30 days after transfusion. There will be pancytopenia, fever, liver enzyme will be elevated, watery diarrhea, and erythematous skin like erythroderma and desquamation of skin will be there. It's a very rare but fatal condition that has a 90% mortality rate. Symptoms appear after about 12 days, may be caused by donor lymphocytes also, and pancytopenia is a result of immunological responses. Even any components that contain T lymphocytes should be irradiated to prevent the GVHD. And this is post-transfusion purpura, it's not that much common. It's a rare complication, it's a rapid onset of thrombocytopenia as a result of anamnestic production of platelet alloantibody. Usually occurs in multiparous women who do not have the antigen. So even some patients have iron overload because of in thalassemia, we can have multiple transfusion. The patient is more prone for getting iron overload. One unit of platelet results as 250 milligram of iron. Okay, so on chronic transfusion, iron will accumulate because are getting multiple transfusion that will cause hemosiderosis. If it is tissue, it is hemochromatosis. Heart, liver, and all these glands are affected. Muscle weakness, fatigue, weight loss, mild jaundice, anemia. These are all the common symptoms and signs. So occurs in individual who receive the multiple transfusions and liver, heart, if it macrophage accumulation be there, torpor in the cells may lead to organ failure. Iron therapy is a treatment for this patient. So now we can go for TBI. So these are all the most common infection. It can be easily transferred to the blood transfusion. It's a very viva question for you. HBV, HCV, retrovirus, CMV, EBV, parvovirus, and the prion diseases. So these are all the infections most common during transfusion. You should screen before the blood transfusion, actually. In our lab, most commonly screening done is HIV 1 and 2 and HPS AG antigen, HCV, malaria, and syphilis. Definitely, they will ask this viva question for you. So, thank you for your patience. Any doubts, you can mail to this my mail ID also.